Oh wow, you're so talented. This is a very common exclamation of praise in our culture. But is it worth it, or are we underrating hard work? This is what is our video all about. In this video, we'll be discussing about a book written by Matthew Sayed. In this book, the author explores the examples from the field of sports, from the field of mathematics, and the field of music. The author busts certain myths: the myth of meritocracy, the overrating of the talents, and the third important thing that he emphasizes is the power of practice. And this is what we are going to see in this lecture: how hard work can transform our life, and how hard work has that immense amount of potential that can help us develop the skills that we require for an outstanding performance in any aspect of our life. So the first thing that the author emphasizes is the intensity of practice, or intensive practice, or hard work. He says that outstanding abilities, they come from a vast range of rigorous practice rather than natural talents. We know, guys, that Mozart was a living legend that is considered to be the greatest amongst the composers. And how could he do that? It was not because of his ability, but the amount of rigorous practice that he had. What we see on the surface is his talent and his outstanding achievements and the miracles that he performs. But what we fail to miss is the immense amount of practice that he had put up in his childhood, during his days of growth, and during the stages of his development, putting himself and exposing himself to newer and newer experiments. Research has come up, guys, that if you want to excel in something, it is the 10,000 hours of rigorous practice that you need to put in to develop these exceptional abilities that you want to develop. Generally, what happens is we try to put in certain things, we learn certain things, and after we have learned, we lose our control. Second important thing that the author emphasizes is that keep challenging yourself. What happens with every one of us, guys, is that we learn certain things, we learn new things, we practice them, and after a certain point of time, we don't give attention to them, or we don't practice them as often. That is why our abilities that we have developed, they develop onto a very mediocre or a much lower level. What the author says is that top performers, however, vary in this aspect. What they do is they aren't content with the amount of tasks they have mastered. They want to go for more. They want to learn more. So they keep on pushing themselves and learning new things, exposing themselves to learning new skills and new talents and new sets of things. Such attempts to perform tasks that are beyond our reach, this is what forces us for development and growth. So the key message over here is keep striving for those skills that are beyond your reach. The next important thing that the author emphasizes is the mind and the great role it plays in success. It is basically our belief about ourselves that defines the scale of our success. The more we believe in ourselves, the more our mind believes in ourselves and gives us that confidence, the more will be the scale of our activity and the scale of our success. But if we tend to have a limiting belief, if we tend to have a limiting system, that will limit our performance and will bring us down to a very mediocre level. Second important thing about mind is that, guys, if you don't believe that you are going to win, you will not be putting your maximum effort. So this part of our mind training is extremely important. You need to approach the task with a win-win mindset that increases and enhances the performance. The third thing about the mindset or the mind is that intensive practice changes the way your brain works. And this happens in two special ways. Firstly, an expert's brain have learned to read the complex situation of that field in a unique way. And the second one is that an expert who has trained himself uses different parts of the brain to perform a task than as compared to a novice. This is how the performance of your mind and your brain helps in enhancing the way of expertise that you develop. The next important idea that the author stresses is that you should be clear about illusions and reality. Be very clear. Be very clear about reality and the situation that you are in, so that you are not fooled around and you avoid illusions. In the book, author gives a very interesting picture of Charlie Chaplin. From the front of the picture, you see a different Charlie Chaplin. It is convex in the front and concave from the inside. Then the image is being slowly rotated. There are a set of four images, A, B, C, and D. So it's slightly rotated, then slightly rotated, then to 180 degrees, and then complete rotation. Now what you see is the inside of that face mask of Charlie Chaplin, which is concave. But what you actually see in that is a completely different image of Charlie Chaplin. The concave appears convex and the convex appears concave. The image is totally different from what you see. That is why it is very important, guys, to get hold of the reality of a situation that you are in. And that is what the experts or these performers have developed with repeated practice. Firefighters, for example, have a very deep knowledge and understanding about the fire. They know how to combat a raging blaze. They have learned to pick up subtle visual cues by looking at the dynamics of the fire. And this is what helps an expert, a firefighter, to fight the fire out, how much intense it may be. In the end, guys, what we need to understand is achieving success in any field is about practicing relentlessly and continuously. Achieving more and more, getting up or pushing yourself to the new limits and acquiring more and more new skills. Don't look for quicker or convenient things. Just look at your life that you have. Look at the achievements that you have in life and just try to find out one example that you may have achieved without any hard work or with a shortcut or a quick solution. That is impossible, guys. And this is what is the key message in this book. It is the practice and not the talent that is of immense importance in our behavior as far as achieving success in our life is concerned. Hope you have liked our video. Do subscribe to our channel and click the notification bell icon so that you are notified whenever our new video is released. Thank you very much and hope to see you in the next video.